Despite the many troubling trends in our media culture, the movie's response to the Iraq War has been, gasp, surprisingly admirable. Since the mid-2000s, a steady stream of films have artfully addressed war's aftermath and the home front, from Stop Loss and In the Valley of Elah, to Grace's Gun and The Messenger, and maybe even American Sniper. We may not agree with, or even like, all of these works, but they represent serious efforts to depict how the conflict bled out into the world beyond the battlefield. Richard Linklater's Last Flag Flying, based on Daryl Ponizan's 2005 novel, follows three Vietnam veterans who reunite to retrieve the returning body of a young man killed in Iraq. As such, it's somber and respectful, and even has a couple of genuinely powerful moments, but none of it's enough to transcend its oppressive dreariness. Ponizan's original book was actually a sequel to his cult 1970 novel The Last Detail, which was filmed so masterfully by Hal Ashby in 1973. The author also co-wrote the script for Last Flag Flying, but the characters have been changed somewhat for the movie version. I've not read Ponizan's books, but there's a world of difference between the Ashby classic's three sharply drawn, riveting personalities and the cliched trio of old-timers we find ourselves faced with here. The film opens with almost supernaturally shy recent widower Larry Duck Shepard, Steve Carell, entering a seedy bar owned by his old Marine buddy, gruff boozer Sal Neelan, Brian Cranston. Together, they go to visit another comrade, Richard Mueller, Lawrence Fishburne, a one-time wild man who is now a married pastor and a beacon in his community. The boozer, the priest and the introvert, these are boilerplates rather than characters. And without much to do, they never really come alive.